हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू ई विज्ञान गर्ल। टुडे वी विल बी सॉल्विंग आईआईटी जैम बायोटेक 2018 पेपर। द सेक्शन बी कंसिस्ट ऑफ 10 क्वेश्चंस। ईच क्वेश्चन इज ऑफ 2 मार्क्स। देयर इज नो नेगेटिव मार्किंग, बट ईच क्वेश्चंस कैन हैव वन और मोर देन वन करेक्ट आंसर। पार्शियल आंसर्स विल नॉट बी गिवन एनी मार्क्स। Antibody binds to an antigen through weak non-covalent interactions. All the interactions which are given here weak and non-covalent. Thus, all of them are correct answer. Plasmid-mediated antibiotic resistance in bacteria acquired by. Plasmid is an extra chromosomal circular DNA present in the bacteria. Now, this plasmid resistance, perfect example are penicillin and kinemycin resistance, where there is transfer of antibiotic resistance genes which are present in the plasmid. The other two genes, quinolin and trimethoferrin resistance genes, are present in the main chromosome. Thus, only A and B are the correct options. Which of the following statement is correct for G-protein coupled receptor mediated signaling? To understand this, let us look at GPCR signaling. GPCR is a transmembrane receptor with 7 membrane spanning regions. This is associated with a heterotrimeric G-protein which has alpha, beta, gamma subunits. This protein, when in inactivated state, is bound to an ADP. When the ligand comes and binds to the receptor, the ADP of G protein gets converted into ATP. Here in the given option, only A and B are correct options. Glucose is incubated with enzymes of glycolytic pathway, except pyruvate kinase, gamma 32-phosphate ATP and unlabeled inorganic phosphate. Which of the following product is formed? To understand this, we should understand what glycolysis is. We know that the enzyme pyruvate kinase is used to convert PEP into pyruvate. The four options given here, none of them are PEP. Thus, we would not be needing the enzyme pyruvate kinase. Now, the second part of the question, if you notice, they have given only the 32-phosphate ATP are labeled, whereas the inorganic phosphate are unlabeled. So when we look at all the four structures, we can see that all the four have phosphate group. But when we look at the 1,3-biphosphoglycerate closely, we know that glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate in addition to an inorganic phosphate becomes 1,3-biphosphoglycerate. Thus, this inorganic phosphate addition will not be radially activated. Thus, our 1,3-biphosphoglycerate will not be radioactive and only A, B, D will be formed. In a double stranded DNA, which of the following ratios is always equal to 1? A, T, G, C and denote the number of bases. We know that when we talk about the double stranded DNA, the first thing which comes into our mind is Chagov's rule. What does Chagov's rule state? It states the percent of adenine will be always equal to the percent of thymine. The percent of guanosine will be always equal to the percent of cytosine. So we know that there is this A equal to T and G is equal to C. So when we add A plus G, it will obviously be equal to C plus T. Or when we add G plus T, it will be equal to A plus C. So thus ratio are seen here in the B and D option. Thus B and D are correct options. Consider the equation x cube minus 1 is equal to 0. If one of the solutions to this equation is 1, the other solution is. So first let's understand how did this 1 come. So when you break x cube, you can break it into two parts. You can break it as x minus 1 and x square plus x plus 1. So when we solve x minus 1 and equate it equal to 0, we get the value of x is equal to 1. Now, when we solve x square x plus 1, we get the value 1 plus or minus root 3i by 2. If we equate it further, we can get it as minus 1 by 2 plus or minus root 3 by 2i. And the correct option here thus would be A and D option. Which of the following statement is slash are correct regarding self-inductance of a long solenoid having cross-sectional area A, length L, and having n turns per unit length filled with the material of relative permeability mu r? To understand this, let us just put the self-inductance formula, which is mu r mu naught n square A by L. So we know from this that the geometry of the solenoid is very, very important. The cross-sectional area will also be important, and the relative permeability of the medium will be important. Thus, A, C, and D are correct options. If an optician prescribes a corrective lens of power minus 2D, the required lenses. So let's put it in the focal length formula. We know that focal length will be equal to 1 by diopter. So here, focal length will be equal to 1 by minus 2, which is about minus 0.5 meter. Now, we have to convert this into centimeters as the answers are given in centimeter. We know that minus 0.5 meter will be equal to minus 50 centimeter. Now, this 50 centimeter is a negative. And when the lens focal length is negative, we know that the lens is concave. Thus, A and D would be correct answers. Which of the following statements is slash are correct? Absorption occurs at all wavelengths if light passes through a given solution. The efficiency of photochemical process is often expressed in terms of quantum yield. The unit of molar extinction coefficient is liter mole per centimeter. The extent of absorption in a dilute solution would be same if the concentration is doubled and the path length of the light passing through solution is halved. The A option we know is completely wrong, as well as C. Whereas B and D, if we look at it, D just states the Beer-Lambert's law. Thus, B and D would be the correct answer. Which of the following pairs of compounds can be distinguished by iodoform test performed in ammonium hydroxide? To show positive iodoform test, we require a free methyl group. Here, only the option A and D would have those free methyl group. Thus, A. Let us see section C. Section C consists of NAT, which is numerical answer type. So you would be given a question and you have to derive answers for it. There will not be any options and there is no negative marking. The total number of genetically different types of gametes that will be produced by a heterozygous plant carrying the genotype AA, B, small b, C, small c is. Now we should know the formula 2 to the power n is equal to number of gametes, where n is the number of heterozygous pair. Here, B and C are heterozygous pairs. Thus, we have two heterozygous pairs. So 2 to the power 2, which is equal to 4. So the answer would be 4. A healthy individual has a cardiac output of 5.5 liter and heart rate of 72 beats per minute. The stroke volume of the individual is, we have to understand the formula of cardiac output into 100 by heartbeat will be equal to stroke volume. Thus, here it would be 5.5 into 100 by 72, which would be about 77.6. Here it is given in ml, so we can take it as 76 to 77 ml. Both strands of a DNA molecule are labeled with radioactive thymidine and are allowed to duplicate in an environment containing non-radioactive thymidine. The number of DNA molecules that will contain radioactive thymidine after three duplications is. So we begin in this question only with two strands of DNA which have radioactive thymidine. No matter how many generation or duplication occurs, there will always be two molecules of radioactive thymidine. Thus, even after 3 generations, the number of DNA molecules which will have radioactive thymidine would be 2. The number of cycles required for complete degradation of palmitic acid, which is a 16-carbon acid, by beta oxidation is. So we know that the number of cycles of fatty acid in beta oxidation degradation would be n by 2 minus 1. So here there is 16 carbons, right? So 16 by 2 would be 8, 8 minus 1, which is 7. Thus, we would require 7 such cycles to occur. The value of log n 4 to the power minus 16 is minus 32. The value of n is. Now we know we can write this in another form. We can write it in the form of n log n x, right? So that would be minus 16 log n 4 will be equal to minus 32. Now we remove the minus 16 and 32 by dividing it by whole thing by minus 16. Thus we get it as log n is 4 is equal to 2. Now again, further division, we see that log n 2 is equal to 1. This can only happen if the base is equal to the integer which we have. Thus, n should be equal to 2. The determinant of the matrix given here is, so we know that we usually take the one which has the least number, so it is easy for us to calculate. So I'm going to take the first row. So first, what we would do, with respect to 1, we would see that the cofactors which here are 6, which we multiply it by 2, and then minus 4 into minus 1. Minus, because plus minus plus, we use that form. So minus 3 into, the cofactors of 3 would be 2 into 2 minus 4 into minus 1. So when we solve this, we get it as minus 8. We know that in capacitor, if two capacitors are a parallel, we will add them as C1 plus C2. Whereas if two capacitors are in series, we would use the formula 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3 and so on. Here, the first place you can see that here two capacitors are parallel to each other. So they would be 4. And the other big diagram, you can see that all of them are parallel to each other. So 4. So it would become 1 by 4. Plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4, as all of these four systems are in series with each other, such that you would get it as 4 by 4 into 10 to the power minus 6 Faraday, which is microfaraday. So the answer would be 1 microfaraday. The stability of the following carbocation arises from hyperconjugation with dash number of hydrogen atoms. So we know that the number of hydrogen atom is based on the alpha hydrogens which are present. These alpha hydrogens will be connected with alpha carbon. So here you can see that there are two alpha carbons. Each methyl group will represent a alpha carbon. So there are three hydrogens attached to the alpha carbon. Thus totally you would be having six alpha hydrogen in this structure. Oxidation state of Fe in the complex FK3FeCN5NO is. So we can see that in further question, we know that the oxidation state of K, potassium is always plus 1, nitrogen is always minus 1, and NO is always plus 1. So using the formula in which we do in redox, we can get it in the sum of 2 plus x minus 5 plus 1. Thus we get the value of x as 2. That is, the oxidation of ferrous is 2. The mechanism of the following reaction involves the formation of a dash membered ring. We can see that in this complex, there's addition of 3 phenyl ring. Thus, in the intermediate, there will be addition of 3 phenyl ring to the already existing ring. Thus, there will be 4 rings attached. So the correct answer would be, there would be a 4 membered ring. The concentration of a purified enzyme is 10 mg per milliliter. 10 microliters of the enzyme solution in a total reaction volume of 1 milliliter catalyzes the formation of 20 nanomoles of the product in 1 minute under optimum condition. The specific activity of the enzyme is.
Specific activity is equal to variation by time into the molar concentration of the enzyme into one micromoles, which is equal to 20 into 10 to the power minus 3 by 10 into 1 into 10 to the power minus 2, which would be equal to 0.2. A 100 nucleotide long single-stranded poly A is synthesized from adenosine monophosphate at physiological pH. The molecular mass of resulting poly A at physiological pH is. So we know that there will be 100 molecules of AMP. So we have to multiply this 100 into 345. We also know as we add two molecules, a water molecule would be released. 99 such water molecule would be released. So we subtract this 34,500 by 1782, which is what we get. And then the answer would be about 32,718. If a colorblind woman marries a normal man, the chance that their boy child will be colorblind is dash percent. So we know that for a woman to be colorblind, she should have both the genes of colorblindness, as it is a recessive trait. Thus, and we also know that in boy, for a boy child, one X chromosome will be from mother and the Y chromosome will be from father. As here, both of the X chromosomes have the gene for color blindness, the boy child will be 100% colorblind. For a 0.1 molar aqueous solution of lysine, the pH at which it carries no net charge is. We know that the pH where it doesn't carry any net charge is called the pI. So here we can calculate the pI by adding the 10.8 and 8 amino groups. So we would get pKa1 plus pKa2 by 2, which is 8 plus 10.8 by 2, which is 9.4. You would think why we did not add the 3.1. Well, we always add the pHs which are near to each other and then divide them by 2. Thus, we have taken here only the 10.8 and the 8.1. For alpha, the following simultaneous equation have an infinite number of solution. So we know that for alpha to be having infinite number of solution, it should be in the form A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2, which is equal to C1 by C2. So when we solve it, we get A about 25. If A and B are events such that P of A is equal to 0.3, P of B is equal to 0.2, P of A union B is equal to 0.45, the value of P of A intersection B is. We can see that from formula we know P A union B is equal to P A plus P B minus P A intersection B. From here we derive that the P intersection B will be equal to 0.045. But in this question, they have asked us PA intersection B dash. Thus, we would minus PA minus PA intersection B to obtain PA intersection B dash. Thus, we would get the answer about 0.25. Ultrasound of signal of frequency 50 kHz is sent vertically down into a medium. The signal gets reflected from a depth of 25 mm and returns to the source in the seconds after it is emitted. The wavelength of the ultrasound signal in the medium is. So we can tell that the speed of this ultrasound signal, we multiply the 25 into 2 because it is going to come back and divide it by the time it has taken. Now we would get it in millimeter, right? So we would convert it into meter. Now we use the formula V is equal to n lambda. So we already know what V is. We just have to find lambda. So lambda would be nothing but V by N, which would be around 2 centimeters. Lambda is nothing but the wavelength of the ultrasound signal. The relationship between the applied force on a body and its displacement is given below. The total amount of work done in the moving the body from X to X4 is. So we can see if you look at this figure, you can draw a rectangle and a triangle. So when we draw a triangle and a rectangle, we can make point as A, B, C, D, E, F, such that area of A, B, F plus area of C, D, E will be equal to the amount of work done. So that is half into 2 into 3 plus 4 into 2, which would be about 11 joules. The number of axial CH bonds in the major product of given reaction is, when this reaction occurs, we would see that with the Grignard reagent and in an acidic medium, 5 axial bonds can be created. Thus, the answer would be 5. A first order reaction is 87.5% complete at the end of 30 minutes. The half-life of the reaction is. So first we have to find what the lambda is to determine the half-life. So we would use the formula n is equal to n naught e to the power lambda by t. From there, when we find out the lambda, we would find out t half. T half is nothing but minus 0.693 by lambda. So here the t half would be about 10 minutes.